Hey, what's up, y'all? It's your boy Ant. I'm at my studio right now in Brooklyn. About to go meet my boy Will, and we're gonna sit down and talk about Cry Today, Smile Tomorrow. It's the song we wrote together for episode 6, season 2 of She's Gotta Have It. And we wanna tell you the story behind it. So, love y'all. Hope you enjoy it. There's a lyric video to follow immediately after. So, see you at the end. Will and I got connected to an organization called Katie's Art Project that is was founded by a friend of mine, Stephanie Clemens. We met doing Hamilton on Broadway together. And the organization, they bring together patients with terminal illnesses and artists. And they bring them together for a day and they just create. They create something that is inspired by the patient. Whether it's a painting, whether it's a song, it could be a dance. But telling the story of the patient, and that's how we met an incredible young lady named Darielle.
Hi, my name is Darielle Cadet. I was born and raised in Trinidad and Tobago, and now I live in Brooklyn, New York. I met Anthony and Will through Sonia at my hospital. She came up to me on my birthday, which is March 14th, and asked me, do you want to write a song with Broadway? And I said, okay.
Even through the phone, right? Like when we spoke to her?
The first phone call was crazy.
Yeah.
It was beautiful, man. We got on the phone, Stephanie had set it up, and we were talking to her, and I believe even her nurses were there in the background and everything.
Oh, yeah.
She sounded so excited.
I got a call from them the same day. And they introduced themselves, what they do, and they were excited to see me. And after that, we set up our first appointment, which was April 14th. We met and we wrote the song in one day.
Yeah. What's up?
Hi.
How you doing?
I'm fine.
Nice to meet you.
Remember that day? It was such a beautiful day outside.
It was beautiful.
And we were sitting in these four walls, no windows, and Ant goes, yo, let's go to the park. I feel like going to the park. We should go by the water. It's too beautiful outside to be inside. We took a walk down there and I brought the guitar and we started messing around with some ideas, some melodies, and Darielle had never written a song before.
My first thing was, how am I supposed to write a song? I have never written a song or sang a song before then. I don't sing, I don't write music, I don't do anything at all music related because I never thought I had any talent or any gifts or any of that.
It's always beautiful to rediscover that process with somebody and to, you know, when those moments of inspiration hit. But I think one of the bigger moments was when Anthony asked her, you know, is there anything that you carried with you through this process or that's kept you strong the whole time? And she hit us with the line.
They need to pay these nurses more, man. They handle a lot. And I was the oldest patient on the floor that day. And, you know, I was crying in the shower because that's why I do my crying. And you know, she's a nurse, you tend to lose a lot of, unfortunately, dignity in the hospital because you need these people to look at you and make sure you're okay. So she came in and we're talking and I'm in the shower and I'm crying. And she tells me, you know, it's okay, you know, you cry today and you smile tomorrow. And I kept those words with me through everything and I translated that to Anthony and Will, and that became the hook of the song.
And I was like, I think we both in.
Yeah,
like,
that was one of the pen drop moments. Oh,
I was just like, hold up.
It means everything to me because every day is a new day. Every day I'm alive, it's another opportunity to change something that's wrong in my life or create a new path for myself. So if yesterday was bad and I do all my crying, I leave it in the past and I move on to a new day.
Every lyric is about her. Every lyric is about something she said to us. I said, what's one thing that maybe annoys you about this situation? And she said, I got problems and everybody tries to point them out to me all the time, but I know I got problems and I know what they are. I don't need you to tell me. And I was like, it's the first line.
I'm at the mercy
of all my
doctors around me, but you can change doctors to something else.
December 19th, I decided to go into the ER that night because I couldn't walk because I was in so much pain. And I had a nasty cold and a cough at the time. And when I came in with my initial problems, I told the doctor, you know, by the way, I have this really nasty cough and cold. I've been taking a whole bunch of medicine and nothing's working. If you can just look at it. And they just so happened to look. And they sent me for a CAT scan, and there was a tumor just lit up like a Christmas tree in my chest. That was it. They admitted me to the hospital, and now I'm here.
I've got problems, and I'll be the first to call them up. Yeah, I get lonely.
I mean, I remember for me personally, thinking about how this song might apply. I had open heart surgery when I was 13 years old, and the amount of love that I had around me in that process. It's almost as if the lyrics for this song in that case were for my family. People start dipping off. They get afraid of what's gonna happen. It was crazy because you think about it, people are afraid to be your friend anymore because they might lose you. And the willpower that you need to move forward through everyday life, you know, because you know, you're a hazard to some people, or your friendship is a hazard because they're afraid of what they might lose.
It's two things with cancer. It's either you beat it or you don't. If you don't, you're dead. And I have to feel all of this by myself. I don't have the luxury of laying in my own bed because I wasn't at home. I didn't have the support of my friends to come see me because I didn't have any friends. I don't have any family. I actually had family here in the States, and they didn't even bother to come see me at the hospital. It's really hard, because I assume more people would have been there. So, you know, they weren't. It's okay, because I beat it, because I told myself I have a lot to live for. And I wanted to, so I worked really hard. And now I'm here.
She's special. She's unique, and she's so like strong, and her belief and her will and her like her vibe is so infectious, yo. You can't help but to. But to feel it and be inspired by it, you know. So she walked up in there like a queen.
It was my words, it was my soul, it was my struggle, and I'm proud of it. Very, very proud of it. And I'm happy that it is well received. Before they were just doing all my vocals, I was singing it. So Anthony did a scratch vocal after. It's so slow and it's so makes me want to cry. They sat me down and it was like, well, you know, Anthony's on the show. And I'm like, yeah, you know, I've heard about it. I'll be seeing it. And he said, well, Spike wanted Anthony to sing a song in one of the episodes. And Anthony sent maybe 3 or 4 songs to Spike to listen to so he can choose. And I don't know what made him do it, but Anthony decided to send the scratch vocals to which he did of Cry Today, Smile Tomorrow, and he loved it. Spike said it has to be in the show.
And I was like, yo, Spike, do you know the story behind that song? And he was like, nah. And I told him the story, and I was like, yo, I'd love to bring it a set. He's like, bring it a set.
My greatest achievement is beating cancer, but one of the best things that ever happened to me is that I got to be on a TV show set. I get to meet Spike Lee, and my song that I worked with these two incredible artists with is in the show for the whole world to see. And I mean, millions of people have seen this and heard the song, and it's amazing.
She gets up on stage, we brought her up, and it's like Will, Marcell, Fat Joe, Spike, we're all up there, we're all setting up for the next scene. And in between takes, she gives her story to, I mean, like 200 extras, like 100 crew members, like I mean, like it had to be a group of 300 people or something like that. We're
the
just
place was full.
In that room. And I mean, people crying, like it was crazy. It was wild, yo. And we did it about what, like between 8 to 10 times or something like that.
Yeah.
And it was special, you know, like it was just so special that she was there and she got to tell her story like that in that way.
I am guilty of skipping episodes and just going to mine. I'm sorry, Will and Anthony, but I can't help it. I was so excited to see it.
It was really significant to me, like crew members coming up to us individually. Like somebody came up to me and was like, man, that song. You know, it was one of the camera guys, and he was like, man, I was holding back tears trying to film this right. It's like, that's, y'all need to put that out.
Yeah.
And so we are.
Yeah, so we are.
I never thought I'd be here. Never thought I'd have cancer. I never thought I'd do a song and it's now on Netflix for the world to see. I'm very surprised and very happy and just, I'm just grateful that I'm able to be here to see it. That's one thing that I feel the most is grateful.
All the struggles in my life, they teach me how. Teach me how. No, I'm perfectly imperfect. And when it hurts, I just remember there's a purpose. So I'll cry today and smile tomorrow. I'll cry today and smile tomorrow. I'll cry today, smile tomorrow. Cry today, smile tomorrow.
Yo, what's up, y'all? If y'all enjoyed that, click here to subscribe, right here. This thing. Here. That. Push the button.
Boop.
Touch screen phone.
Boop.